Hello everyone, hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Last class, we discussed about crop, we discussed about two kinds of crop, isn't it? And through animation, through pictures, we learned that the two types of crops, kharif and rabi. Now, in this video, we are going to jump into the main content of the chapter. Okay, now, I will show you which part of the textbook I'm going to discuss. For that, I'll share my screen. Just give me a few seconds. I hope that you can see the textbook right now. So we have discussed till here. One second, let me select the pen. We have discussed till here, red color. We have discussed till here, kharif and rabi crops. We have done, completed. Okay, now we are going to jump into the basic practices of crop production. Okay, how the crop is produced. Okay, what are the steps required, steps involved. Okay, so these are the steps which are going to discuss. So we will come back to this NCERT textbook after understanding the steps in brief. So in these steps we need to learn in very, you know, in actually in a large content, but in this video I'm going to just go through all the steps fast. Okay, we will discuss next time, we will discuss each steps in detail and what are the steps also we discuss. Okay, fine. So I'll share my screen once again. I will show that. So before starting this session, I just want to tell you this. At the end of this class, I will give you a special assignment. Don't worry, it's not a written work. Okay, it's not a written work, it's a work which you will like. Okay, fine. That I will tell you at the last climax of this video. Okay, fine. Let's begin then. So last class we have learned about agriculture types of crops. So can you give me an example? Okay, who is the leader of kharif group? How many of you told paddy? Good, very good. So that's the correct answer. Paddy is the correct answer. Okay, now paddy is nothing but rice. Okay, from rice is obtained from paddy only. So we are going to discuss that. Okay, how it is done, how farming is done, basically we are going to discuss. Okay, many of you have a lot of lands for farming, you might have seen by yourself, so a lot of people can easily understand this chapter. Okay, but at the same time, those who are living in the city area, town area, they actually lack information about it. They might have not seen these things by their naked eye. In front of them, they might not have seen. They're just learning through textbook and videos. Okay, so listen carefully. It's easy. Okay, so I'll share my screen. I'll start it. So 1 second. Yeah, I hope you can see which color you want. I'll select yellow now. Okay. Okay, now steps of farming. So what are the steps of farming? Yellow, choose right. Yeah, steps of farming. Okay, now here the first step you can see here, preparation of soil. What do you mean by preparation of soil? So these, actually all the steps like preparation of soil, sowing and all, these steps we will learn in detail in the coming videos. Okay, in this video we are just going to learn, understand briefly about them. Okay, now preparation of soil. See, just everyone please imagine that you have bought 100 acres of land. Okay, each one of you have bought 100 acres of land and you are going to do farming there. Okay, you're going to do the farming. Fine, so you imagine like that you are a farmer and you are going to do this. Okay, and what's your aim, objective? To produce the crop, to produce a good crop which can yield, which can give whatever product it is, fruit or paddy or whatever. Fine. So the very first step which is done actually is preparation of soil. Here you can see preparation. I will increase the size of this. Yeah, preparation of soil. You can see here, right? Now what is preparation of soil? See, if you see a land which is not cultivated, it will be a flat land. It will be a flat land. Now this flat land is digged, not completely. It is actually digged with some tools like plow. The plow, it is digged, not digged actually. That process called plowing. P-L-O-U-G-H-I-N-G, plowing. Now, plowing is done by a special implement or a tool called plow, which you will learn in this next video, not in this video, but that tool is used here. That is the traditional tool. Okay, even other tools are also there, which we Indians use. Apart from that, okay, another tool, even hoe can be used. You know, hoe, H-O-E, hoe. Hoe is used randomly by many people. Okay, now, the Tamil name, I don't know about this hoe, just to find it out and let me know. Okay, because this thing is very common, hoe. Now, modern technology, they use even tractor for plowing. So basically plowing is nothing but disturbing the top part of the land, top part of the farm. Initially the farm is flat and hard actually. Nothing is done, no, so hard and flat, right? Then what is done with the help of plow? Okay, I will show you plow. One second. I'll show you plow. One second. Yeah, now here you can see let me choose one color. Yeah, here you can see a farmer is using cattle. This thing is common, you might have seen, right? In the villages and all, they actually use cattle. Now this cattle is carrying a wooden stick, right? And this is attached to a tool here. This tool looks like this. This tool looks like this. Now this tool is called plow. Okay, plow. Okay, now this is plow. Okay, now different types of plows are there. See here in this picture, this is also plow. This is also another plow. This is also plow. This is also plow. Different types of plows are there. Now even humans can do with hand also plow. Okay, for small lands, big lands, big farms and all, they use cattle in the olden times. Now also some villages they use it. In the modern, in United States and all, don't think that in USA farming is not there. In US also farming is there. Otherwise, from there we will get food. They are using machines, right? Tractor. Even we are also using some places. Okay. So these tractors are used. They have a tool. It's actually called seed drill, which we'll discuss in the coming class. And it actually makes a burrow in the land when the tractor moves. Okay, so that is also done. Now these are the tools. We will discuss exclusively about these tools in another video. Don't worry about it. Just understand this. This is these tools. Now here you can see a man using hoe. This tool is called hoe. Now you understood what is a hoe. See how it looks like. See, this one is hoe. Okay, now this hoe is also used to remove unnecessary crops, so unnecessary plant from the crop land. Also, it can also be used for plowing. Okay, hope you understood. So let me share back that page which we were discussing. I hope you can see. Yeah, so we were discussing the first step, preparation of soil. Understood, no? So preparation of soil is nothing but disturbing the top land of the soil. So land is flat in the beginning. We are using plow and other tools for, and we are disturbing the top layer. When you're disturbing the top layer, the layer becomes loose. The layer, top layer alone becomes loose. Okay, when the top layer alone becomes loose, what happens? What is the benefit of it? Think about it. There are some benefits. Oxygen gas can enter the soil, or from below minerals can come up, bacteria can come up. With whether these things will be helpful or not, think about it. If the future, if the sapling germinates from the seed, it can easily, root can easily grow because soil is loose. If soil is hard, it will be difficult for the root to grow, right? So because all these things, farmers know that. That's why farmers loosen the top layer. Okay, it's also called loosening. Okay, this top layer is actually disturbed and is loosened. Okay, and big soil particles become, farmers make them into small particles by which the plant, or the seed which the farm is going to do so in the next step, can easily germinate and root and shoot can come out easily and root can grow and penetrate into the land much more efficiently than the other case. Understood? So preparation soil is nothing but plowing. Plowing is done. Now plowing is done and top layer of the soil is disturbed, and so that is the first step. Briefly only I'm explaining. We will explain these in detail in the coming class. The second step, you can see what is the second step here? Sowing. I don't know why this person is doing moon work here. Looks like he's doing moon work. Well, you can do moon work and do sowing, no problem in that. Okay, fine. So here sowing is being happening. Now what is sowing? Now sowing is nothing but burying the seed. Now sowing also can be done in different techniques. Okay, we have modern technique also, classical test technique also. I don't want to go into detail because if I discuss everything in detail, it will be longer. Video will be longer, so don't worry. So sowing is nothing but just burying the seed, whichever crop. I told you, imagine that you have 100 land. So first step, what you did, you used tractor and may have plowed the entire farmland. After plowing, what you did, you are burying the seed. Okay, whichever plant, whichever crop you want, imagine that, and you're putting the seed there. So that step of distributing the seed in the farm is called sowing. Now sowing also, a lot of things, as I told you, another video we will discuss that. Third step, it is third step is adding manures and fertilizers. Now after sowing, definitely the plant, sapling, the small baby sapling comes out, shoot comes out, root comes out. You know, happiness which farmers get after doing, after when that happens, it's amazing. Now after that sapling comes out, what happens? Farmers add manures and fertilizers. Now manures and fertilizers is a difference we'll learn in the coming classes, but just briefly I will tell you. Manure is organic in nature, like cow dung, like, you know, animal product, leaf, decomposed leaf, and all these things are manures. Fertilizer means chemical in origin. They are produced in factories. Both are good for the plant. Disadvantage, advantage, we will learn in a separate video. So basically, adding manure fertilizer. Why they are adding manure fertilizer? Because these plants require nutrients to grow. Not only you, plants also require nutrients. You have in your advertisement and all, you are saying, you know, Horlicks contains vitamin this, that, and all, isn't it? The same way, plants also require nutrients, and we are providing. We are not putting Horlicks there, Boost there. Right, instead of that we are putting manures and fertilizers there. Okay, because the plants also require nutrients, so we are putting manures and fertilizer for the proper growth, so they will grow. Not only nutrients and fertilizer, they also need sunlight. So sunlight also they are doing, right? We don't need to do anything, right? Because it is getting sunlight by itself. But it also need water. Now what, some farmland it is difficult for the farmers to get the water, so they need to do another process called irrigation. Now, irrigation is nothing but watering the cropland. Okay, providing water to the cropland is called irrigation. Again, many types of irrigation that are there, we will discuss in another video. So irrigation, so after irrigation is what is done, weeding. What do you mean by weeding? Weeding is nothing but removing the unwanted crops. See, for example, in a farmland, I told you, oh, you're done plowing, you are done sowing, you have added manures and fertilizer, you've done irrigation. Definitely with the, say, you have planted mango tree, for example. Mango tree will come out definitely. With the mango tree, maybe some other unwanted plants might also come out. Say, for example, grass. Okay, right. And now you don't want grass. Why you don't want grass? Because grass also will use this fertilizer and manures, no? So the mango tree will not get dried. So we need to remove this unwanted plant which is growing by nature from this farmland. That process is called weeding. Weeding is called nothing but removal of the unwanted plant from the cropland. You should not say that removing the crop. The crop is always essential. Unwanted thing is not crop. Okay, that's called plant. Fine. So removing the unwanted plant from the cropland is called weeding. After that, harvesting. Now, what is harvesting? After some time, the crop will grow up, and say for the example, mango tree. I told you, after mango tree grows up, mango comes out, right? Forms mango fruits. These fruits are taken out after it ripens. So that is called harvesting. In the case of paddy, the grains are taken out. Okay, grains are taken out. The entire stalk is taken out. Okay. Wheat also in the same case. So that's called harvesting, taking out the plant from the cropland. Okay, so it's called harvesting. Now harvesting also can be done manually. In the picture you can see, the same way it can also be done with machines, like Okay, we have machines which can take the combiner, for example. We'll learn that in the coming video. Then the threshing. Now, threshing, do you remember? Sixth standard, you learned. Threshing is nothing but beating the stalk in a solid surface. What happens? When you beat it, what happened? The grain comes out from the stalk. And these grains are separated from the stalk, which is nothing but your rice, your wheat, whatever. Then these things are stored in a proper place. And later on, it is transported and distributed where it is required. So these are the steps in the farming. Okay, any crop can be has to undergo all the steps. This sequence is very important. First, preparation of soil. Second, sowing. Third, adding manures and fertilizer. Fourth, irrigation. Fifth, weeding. Sixth, harvesting. Seventh, threshing and storage. The last two steps, you can avoid threshing if you want, because in all the crop, it is not there. So you can avoid this step. Okay, after harvesting, you can remember storage. Fine. Clear? Am I clear? So this, I don't want to discuss much more, because I don't want to, don't want to put many information in your head right now. It's okay. We will complete the entire chapter slow, one step by step. And I'm confident about my children, my students. You people are brilliant and you people will do it. Okay. So don't worry. So fine. So I hope you understood. So one of you a student complained, actually said, don't summarize, because you're asking question before summarizing, so people will get it that. Okay, fine. Clear. So I'll ask question now. Okay. One question from the textbook, remaining question from the video, which right now you saw. So first I will ask the question from the video. Number one, what is the process? Now, name two tools which is used for plowing. Name two tools which is used for plowing. Number two means second question. Why we need to do plowing? Why it's necessary to do plowing? Third question. Okay, third question. Which step comes before adding manures and fertilizer? Which step in farming comes before adding manures and fertilizers? Fourth question. In a flow chart, write down the entire steps of farming. In a flow chart, in the form of flow chart, write down the steps in farming. I think four questions over. Now, one question from the textbook. I'll show you the page from which I'm asking. One second. I think I... No, it's here. Yeah, so I'm going to ask question from this page. Okay. Fine. Okay. One second. It is so. Yeah, from this page on, I'm asking question. Fifth question is, briefly describe about weeding or protecting from weeds. Okay, protecting from weeds or weeding. Please describe it in a brief way. Okay, easy. So I hope you understood. Okay, and in the next video, each step we will discuss in detail. Okay, with the tools. Okay, fine. So be safe, be happy, keep smiling, and make others also smile. Okay, because your smile matters. Okay, so Anurag signing out.